Now, the thinking process with producing the Marcellus and developing the Marcellus really starts with the geology. It starts with the reservoir. There needs to be a relative amount of confidence that when and where we go drill, that there's going to be commercial quantities of gas at our target.
When we start, typically we'll pick an area that we think is viable in terms of first geologic considerations. We look at fractures and faults, and even if the Marcellus is present in a viable location, we'll look at any floodplains, location of homes, anything, access roads that would either be favorable or not favorable to development. So we tend to avoid, you know, environmental features such as wetlands, streams, things such as that. So we try to look for areas that are somewhat flat for building well pads, makes for easier construction.
The Marcellus Shale is a shale that ranges from 5,000 to 8,000 feet deep from the surface. It can range anywhere from 100 to 400 feet thick, depending on where you're at in the basin.
Initially, we have to run a PNDI, which is a Pennsylvania Natural Diversity Inventory analysis, and that looks at threatened and endangered species. So we have to avoid those, and if we encounter them, we have to mitigate or find ways to mitigate, working with the state agencies. We also have to consider historic things, such as archaeological and historic buildings.
We have to look, you know, 12 to 16 months out, and the planning part of it involves numerous disciplines, numerous people with diverse backgrounds, ranging from geology to reservoir engineers, operations people, land staff, drilling staff, completion staff, even, you know, regulatory and community relations people. It is a massive effort and a complex effort to plan these types of developments.
When we first site a pad, we will go to the landowner with a concept plan, basically, that shows the location of the pad relative to their property, their homes, their fields, their barns, and we get their buy-in. And before we start construction, that's a must. So we have to consider their operations, how they use their land. They're a partner in this with us.
I think the best way for folks to learn about the drilling process is actually to see it for themselves. We're happy to give rig visits or rig tours. We work with a lot of groups and do that. They get to see the process in action, see the technology, because there's so much involved with this. It's not something that people can really understand until you actually see it happen. And we're talking about taking a drill bit and sending it a mile to a mile and a half underground, and then sending it out from there, once you're underground, another mile away. So it's a phenomenal process. And so once they get to see that and really understand it and really see what it takes to do that, they'd be really impressed. And I think they'll learn so much from that.